Members of Parliament from the Western Region have petitioned government to widen the scope of vulnerable poor groups and consider lockdown has affected categories of people from the Western Region. Addressing the press today at Parliament, legislators cried out that Western Uganda has been equally ravaged by the lockdown like other regions and debunked myths portraying Western Uganda as a region full of wealthy people. Take a look.
We want the government to consider the border districts and town councils that are not working.
The delayed release of COVID relief support to lockdown-affected households is causing more anxiety among the public. Today, a group of members of parliament from Western Uganda addressed the press and petitioned government to widen the scope of the vulnerable poor people to receive 100,000 shillings to include affected persons in rural areas.
As the way things go now, the Right Honourable Prime Minister and her team are targeting vulnerable people in cities and municipalities. Apart from my colleague here from Rukunjiri, who is from Rukunjiri municipality, the rest of us are from what we'd call rural constituencies. But those rural constituencies also have urban centers. So what are we here for?
I add my voice of appealing to the Prime Minister's office to consider these people from our rural constituencies as vulnerable people.
Basil Bataringaya, the Kashari North Member of Parliament who led the group, noted that Western Uganda has been equally affected by the lockdown like any other region in Uganda. He denounced myths which depict Western Uganda as a well-off region.
The lockdown does not choose who comes from west, north, south, and vulnerability is not for a section or a given area of Uganda. Mm-hmm. In Western Uganda, because if vulnerable people that are being chosen are, for example, border people or private teachers or people who are carrying bags or baggage in towns, people who are surviving on day-to-day basis, they do not exist only in a given part of this country. Even in Western Uganda, they are there. That is a myth.
MPs from Western Uganda reported that their constituents have resorted to insulting them directly after waiting for a long time for government financial support.
The more that people get hungry, they become angry. They start to communicate to us in a different way. At first they beg, but when you show them that you cannot feed all of them, they start even to insult. We are requesting the government to see how they can be handled. As much as some would benefit from that 100,000, others will not.
We want to thank the government for what they are doing right now, but we want them to quicken up the process, and we want them to put in more effort to make sure that everybody receives what they deserve. When you look at people who have been even making 5 million, the moment you put lockdown, those people no longer make that much money, and they don't have even income. So they are vulnerable too.
Juliet Bashisha, the Bitoma District Woman MP, asked the government to evacuate the vulnerable people who are stranded in city suburbs but willing to go back to their villages. She noted that the lockdown caught many vulnerable people in urban centers.
Our people in the cities, especially Kampala, those who are not on the list, I am requesting that maybe they provide transport, free transport for those, they can be tested first. And they provide free transport for those who are able to go to their villages. There are those who have food. There is a lot of food actually in the village, but they cannot go. They don't have the means.
The government considered only 42 cities and municipalities to receive financial support, a thing that has left many legislators whose districts were not considered grumbling. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.